Jesus, the Savior of the world. We are gathered to worship, to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, to remember before God our sister Ramona, to give thanks for her life, to commend her to our merciful Redeemer, and to comfort one another in our grief. When we were baptized in Christ, we were baptized into his death. We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Well, God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our sister Ramona. We thank you for giving her to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in victory by our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints, through Jesus Christ our Savior and Lord. Amen. Congregation, please stand. and Danny. Ramona's much-loved grandchildren, Jason, Jeremy, Scott, Jerry, Brian, David, Justin, Lindsay, Cody, Morgan, Katie, Casey, Carla, and Seth. And her 18 great-grandchildren and that one great-great-grandchild. And all of her members, family, and friends, former students. Grace, peace, and comfort to you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. Let us pray. Good and gracious God, in whom we live and move and have our being, we present ourselves before you as a people saddened by loss, seeking the counsel of your truth, the strength of your presence, and the guidance of your wisdom. We are gathered here in this beautiful old church to celebrate the life and give honor to the memory of Ramona Cronick. We have traveled to this church from many different locations, on many different roads, and a variety of different experiences, as numerous as the many different roads we took to get here. You're not used to being together under these circumstances, and some of you are not used to being in this place. It is all the more our prayer that you, O God, will unite us in heart, and mind, and spirit for this little while. Comfort all who mourn with a glorious hope of resurrection and life eternal. Grant us grace to say with a believing heart, "Thy will be done," and to know that your will is a good and gracious will, even when we mourn. If emotion wells up in us, accept our tears as tokens of love for Ramona, and with those tears release us from our hurts and grief, until at last we might truly celebrate her life. Amen. Ramona's family and friends, I did not know Ramona, but I really wish I had. She will be remembered in this community as a wife and a mother and a teacher and a genuine asset to this small community. And speaking of Les told me that she faced her death with courage. She was ready. Actually, she was a little impatient with God because it was getting in Paul's second letter to Timothy, he writes, "As for me, I am already being poured out as a libation, and the time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, there is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day. And not only to me, but also to those who have longed for his appearance." Ramona knew that the time of her departure was close. She knew that she had fought the good fight. She had finished the race. She had kept the faith. I have a favorite poet named Gerard Frost. He was raised on by Minnewaukan, and he was a teacher and a minister and an author of books of poetry. We're about to share a favorite. It's titled "The Hardest Part." "The longer I live, the more assured I am that God leaves the hardest part till last, to stay alive until I die. I'm tempted to withdraw a little every day, to retreat into myself until I'm caught in the slowly swirling current of less and less. I need God's constant help to fight the good fight and stay involved another day." Knowing what I know about Ramona, she stayed involved as long as she lived. She continued to fight the good fight. And Ramona had the dream that many of us have. She got to spend almost all of her adult life on the farm that she and George settled on in 1964. Young people may not understand the pull that a home has. Ramona and George raised their children. She studied and successfully obtained her bachelor's and master's degrees while being a nurse. There are lots of people who fail to have a little bit of success, even without having to stay at home and raise family. But she did it, and I'm amazed. And she became one of my heroes because of her accomplishments. I've heard that she was a much loved teacher. grew up in a small town, you probably don't understand the role a teacher has in your life. Ramona taught school, but she was probably your Sunday school teacher. Maybe she was the mother of your best friend or your future spouse. Ramona knew what to do, and she did it well. And I found out also that she was a very strict disciplinarian. I also learned that Ramona provided care for family members in their later years. What a blessing to be able to be cared for by a family member who provided love as well as the care that they needed. That type of care is very demanding, very demanding. And it takes a special person to do it. And I kind of think that she passed her skill on to Les. I didn't know Ramona, so I didn't get a chance to know George. But in the book of Proverbs, there's a hymn called Hymn to a Good Wife. Proverbs is filled with all kinds of advice for the people of the Old Testament time. Not a whole lot of quality information for us. But I like this song, and I'm going to share some verses of it. A good woman was hard to find, and worth far more than diamonds. Her husband would trust her without reserve, and never has reason to regret her. She shops around for the best yarns and cottons she enjoys knitting and sewing. Les told me that she sewed a set of seat covers, leopard skin print, for its firebird. That is absolutely a woman's love. I also learned that she sewed a wedding dress for a friend of mine. First thing in the morning, she dresses for work, rolls up her sleeves, eager to get started. She senses the worth of her work, is in no hurry to call cooks for the day. She's quick to assist anyone in need and reaches out to help the poor. Many women have done wonderful things, but you outclass them all. These verses, as I said, are from the 31st chapter of Proverbs, from the Message translation of the Bible. So the language is a little unfamiliar. So as we end this day, when we celebrate Ramona's life, a few things to remember. For you who are her grand and great-grandchildren, Grandma Ramona has left you a legacy that you should try to follow. She showed how important it is to love God and your fellow human beings, to be the best employee you can be and share your enthusiasm with others, to love and care for your spouse and your family. In the closing verses of the song from Proverbs, we hear, and she always faces tomorrow with a smile. As we leave, some words of comfort for those of us who are gathered here this morning. From Paul's letter to the Romans in the 8th chapter. Now, these are my favorite verses in all of Scripture, and I'd like to share them with you. Paul writes, who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will affliction, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword, as it is written? No, in all these things we are more than victorious through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Let us pray. O Lord, support us all the day long in this troubled life, until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes and the busy world is hushed. The fever of life is over and our work is done. Then, Lord, in your mercy, grant us a safe lodging and a holy rest and peace at last. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. This time I would like to have the congregation turn in their hymnals to hymn number 779 as we sing Amazing Grace. believe in God,
Father Almighty,
Creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, my only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again.
He ascended into heaven.
He is seated at the right hand of the Father. We will come again to Christ in the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, for the Lord of the Church.
We will continue with the prayers of intercession. The response, God of mercy, the response is hear our prayer. Almighty God and Holy Baptist, you have knit your chosen people together in one communion of saints in the body of Christ. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. God of mercy, grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to share the new life in Christ. God of mercy, give courage and faith to all who mourn, and a sure and certain hope in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may have strength for the days ahead. God of mercy, grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage, who walk as yet by faith, that where this world groans in grief and pain, your Holy Spirit may lead us to bear witness to your life and new life. God of mercy, help us in the midst of things we cannot understand to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. God of mercy, God of all grace, we give you thanks because by his death, our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death. And by his resurrection, he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also. And that neither death nor life, nor things present or things to come, will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us our Lord's Prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Let us commend Ramona for the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. In your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Ramona. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, into the glorious company of the saints in life. We will be proceeding to the cemetery immediately after the service, and after the burial, all are invited back here to the church for a time of fellowship and the sharing of memories.
would be good to be rested. It's really hard for him.
No, tell him to stay here.
Go easy on him.
Thank you.
You can go. Yeah, thank you. Have a good day. Good seeing you.
Is it going to be RTA for the lunch?
Yes, I think so.
So, thank you for that.